Hello and welcome back to the channel. I'm EVM and this is all about these things. Home battery systems. This is my Give Energy 8.2 kilowatt hour battery, and before anyone asks, yes, if I was going to buy another one today instead of a year or so ago, I would still buy the same one. It is still for me the best on the market in this country, and I include the power wall in that one as well. But that's not what this video is about. It's not about this particular battery system. It's about battery systems in general. And why, because of the current energy prices in the UK, electricity specifically, of course, these make a huge amount of financial sense right now. In terms of how much money they will save and therefore the payback period, it makes more sense to get one of these than solar panels. In fact, getting one of these without solar panels makes a ton of financial sense. So that's what I'm going to do on the whiteboard of truth upstairs, show you the facts, figures and sums that I've not just experienced over the last year, but also will experience over the coming years, and what you can as well if you're lucky enough to be able to afford something like this. So ultimately, these, for me, right now, if you've got the money, are almost a financial no-brainer. Now, to explain this whole concept of why a battery makes sense now financially, I'm going to have to explain the type of tariff that makes it make sense. I'm on one called Octopus Go. There are other tariffs with other energy companies that effectively is cheap at night but more expensive during the day. Now, this is what I'm on at the moment. I pay 5p per kilowatt hour for 4 hours at night, and of course for the other 20 hours I pay 15.4p, but that's only because I fixed mine back in May. So for the next year, well, no, until next May, that's what I'm on. If, because of the current ridiculous price rises, I changed it now, or I was a new customer, or I just, you know, it expired, whatever, I wouldn't be paying 15.4p. So this highlights how much electricity has just gone up in the last 6 months alone. It would go from 15.4 to 23.4p from 15. That's a hell of a price increase. And I'm not having to go Octopus on this one. Everyone has gone up a similar amount. Now, the point of this tariff is that this 5p stays the same. It might go up at some point in the future, but all indications are this is where they want to keep it, because using a lot of electricity during the really cheap off-peak period in the middle of the night is beneficial for an energy company. It actually helps them out, makes it cheaper for them. So this is in their interest to keep it like that, which is why it's ultimately designed for electric vehicle drivers, because you can tell your car to charge at night time, every time, and then it's got its own battery to carry on through the day. The house is a bit different though, because without a home battery system, yeah, you'll get 4 hours at 5p and you might be able to move things into that 5p period, like your dishwasher or your washing machine, you know, stuff that are like high load appliances. But you have to use electricity during the day and you're going to have to use it at this price. So it kind of offsets the savings, doesn't it, unless you have an electric vehicle. For this purposes, however, there is no EV in the calculations. Not that it changed anything, but I'm making no EV on this one, no solar panels. So you're not generating your own electricity. This is based on a house that has nothing versus a house that just has a home battery system. And of course, on the tariffs that are available from now onwards, especially after the price cap increases in the next, what, month or two, or whenever it happens. And over the next, let's face it, 6 to 12 months, that's going to go up again, I'm sure of that. It's all about, as you can probably tell, moving as much usage to this period, the 5p. Not just the high load appliances. Imagine if you can move your entire house usage to this 5p period, just like you can with an electric vehicle, because an electric vehicle has a big battery. So you get a battery at home, which has the same sort of benefit as an EV does, and you charge it up at 5p, and then it powers the house throughout the rest of the 20 hours at 23.4p. You're never going to get total zero usage during the day because of inertia and various other fluctuations that you might end up using. You know, the battery might not be big enough to see you throughout that full 20-hour period on every day. Remember, this is about averages. You'll use more in winter than less in summer and so forth. So let's do the sums now. So for an average family house, so this is a family house, not just the UK average, I've used 12 kilowatt hours per day. So that's a family house, not a, you know, where there's one or two of you in a flat or anything like that. I've come to the conclusion that you could quite easily, with an 8.2 kilowatt hour battery, use 10 kilowatt hours during the cheap period and 2 during the expensive period. In part, that's by moving, as I said, some of the high load appliances to the 5P whilst the home battery is charging. And then because of inertia and various other blips here and there, I'm going to say that on average, you use about 2 at the expensive day rate. I've done plenty of days where that's been very, very little, to next to nothing. And I have switched my solar panels off on this one. So it was a pretty accurate test. So all we do now is 10 times 5p, 2 times 23.4p, and that will give us our daily cost for electricity with a home battery system. And then we'll look at the standard rate. 96, or let's call it 97p. Rather than 96.8. So 97p would be, well, an average cost for that electricity on the for a day, effectively. 0.08p, pretty much smack bang on 8 pence per kilowatt hour. Having a home battery has meant that is my average now, and it's easily obtainable by other people. All you need to do is be on a time of day tariff and have that battery system. So now we've got these figures, we can compare it to the flat rate tariffs and what, and you can use it to compare it against what you will be on once you have to change to a different tariff, once yours expires, once the price cap increases in before the end of the year, I believe it is. Here we are, 8 pence per kilowatt hour. Remember, our average daily usage is 12 kilowatt hours. So all I need to do now is say, right, well, let's imagine you were on 20 pence per kilowatt hour day and night. How much would it cost you for that day? And then obviously multiply that by 365 to give us our yearly average. I think between 25 and 30 pence is the UK average now. It's just gone ridiculous. And in another 6 to 12 months, we're probably further down here. So the further into the future we go, logically, the more expensive this will be due to inflation and various other factors. I really do not think, and neither does anybody else in the world, or rather in the UK, think that we are going to drop back down to the prices that we used to, kind of like the 13, 14, 15 pence per kilowatt hour. It's just not going to happen. This is what it's like now. Okay, here we are. So if you are on that 20p, which again, I think is fantasy land now, or by the end of the year will be, you pay £2.40 per day, or the equivalent of £876 a year. 25p, £1,095. 1,314 if you're at 30 pence. So I think that, for me, is the likely one. £1,533 per year, just for electricity, if you're paying an average of 35 pence. So with the battery, we were paying, was it 97 pence per day? Which effectively means that if I just do some quick calculations in my head and not on my phone underneath here. So the with battery figure is, let me do that in a different colour so it's highlighted, £354. That's how much the home battery gives you the benefit of. So what are the savings? Let me now add that to this mix, just so I can talk about it easier. Here are the savings. So now you need to figure out what your average pence per kilowatt hour, and therefore you can do all these sums, is going to be, let's say, January. So if you say, well, I can get an average of 20 pence per kilowatt hour, remember, no solar, no benefits at all, it's just house usage, then you're still gonna save £522 by having a home battery and being on a split rate tariff. If your average, whether you're on a split rate or a flat rate tariff, turns out to be 25p, you will save £741 a year. 30p, I mean, when I went onto British Gas's website, got the cheapest tariff they were gonna offer me right now, it was 30 pence, just over 30 pence per kilowatt hour. So if I compared that against what I'm on now with a home battery, compared to not having it with a home battery, nearly £1,000 a year saving. That's astronomical. 35p? So in a couple of years, certainly 3 years maybe, who can predict? 35p is probably going to be average. The home battery will be saving you not far off £1,200 a year. So this is only going to get more in favour of the battery the higher the price goes compared to the cheap rate. So if the 5p goes to 10p, that will reduce a bit. But I suspect, as I say, because nighttime usage is beneficial and makes the money ultimately for the energy company, because that's when electricity is very cheap, sometimes they'll get paid for it. I don't think that 5p is going anywhere. And again, I'm using Octopus Go as an example, but there are other companies that do this sort of type of tariff. It's just I'm familiar with Go. So if we look at these costs now, how much does the home battery system installed actually going to cost somebody? Because ultimately, if it's a gazillion pounds for one, it doesn't matter what you're saving, does it? So let me give you an idea of what it might cost you for effectively the same system I've got, which is the 8.2 kilowatt hour usable battery system. My installation was very straightforward because they just whacked it on the side of the garage wall, which was next to the consume unit, and it was a straightforward installation. If you want to put yours in the loft and the consume unit's downstairs, it's of course going to increase your cost. So everybody's different. Consider this a fairly standard average. 8.2 battery plus VAT installed. I've been given the average of, that's a terrible pound sign, I apologise, £3,900. So, just shy of £4,000, call it £4,000, I guess, if you will, for that fully installed battery system, and these are your savings. So, I guess, again, you need to figure out where you are on this table to know where your payback period is. If I just quickly grab my calculator and pick 30 pence. Remember, this is only going to go up as the years progress. So if you think you're here now, you'll be down here probably in a year or so. So you've got to factor in inflation as well. So let's say we're saving £850. Let's pick somewhere in the middle. So 3,900 divided by 4.58 years. So that's less than a 5 year payback period. And if the price, as I suspect, does go down here, you're looking at probably less than a 4 year payback period. It depends on how good you are, how much you use. Of course, there are so many variables, which is why all could go off is averages. Ultimately though, I think anything with under a 10 year payback period is, if you have that money to invest, of course, you need that in the first place. This is an awful lot of money. But if you happen to have that and think, well, I've been umming and ahhing about a battery for a while, or should I get solar panels and then a battery? Personally, I would go for the battery before the panels. What are you getting out of a bank? 0.1% or something? Buy one of these and look at the yearly savings. So after 10 years, you're going to have saved thousands of pounds. Right, any questions, please do in the comments section. I've gone through this with a fine-tooth comb. I'm pretty confident in these figures, based on my own experience and again, speaking to other people. If you are looking at a battery system, I personally would stick with Give Energy. That's what I researched and bought a year or so ago myself, and that's what I would still do today. There's a lot of new stuff coming out with them, and I will show you that at some point in the future, especially, of course, if I expand my array to a bigger battery size. Even if you think you're going to be moving soon, because let's face it, a home battery system, certainly compared to solar, very easy to take it with you. An electrician will come and basically unplug everything for you, make it safe. You move it to your new house and then they plug it back in again. You can do that with solar panels, but I think very few people would. So there's a lot of people I've spoken to that said, well, I'm going to get solar panels, but we're planning on moving in a couple of years, so there's no point. Well, that doesn't exist with a battery system. This is a conservative estimate. As the years progress, people will pay more. And I think the gulf between that cheap nighttime and the more expensive daytime rate will do that rather than go up together, as YouTube will probably want me to say. I am not a financial advisor. This is what I chose to do a year ago, partly because of the tariff savings, although they were closer to up here than down here, but partly because of the solar balance, of course. I feel immensely fortunate or should I say, have great foresight that I did that, because now my fuel bills are, without solar, closer to that than they are closer to these. Well, when I say fuel bills, my electricity bills, excluding the car, of course. But when you add solar panels, I'm probably not paying much more than that, including the car. But again, I'm in a fortunate position to have both. Has anybody got a home battery system and seen similar savings? Have you got anything good or bad to say about the, you know, let's use the comment section as a bit of a wiki for people.
As I'm an ultimate professional and I didn't charge all the batteries up for that camera, I've got no charge left and I can't bother charging one just to literally say thanks for watching. And remember, people who are members get this video a week early, they get the podcast early, and there are members only videos as well. And let's face it, if I've just saved you £800 or £1,000 a year, what's 99p a month? Bargain. Okay, sales pitch is over. As I said, thank you for watching. And please do let me know if you've got any ideas or inklings about this. Have you got a battery system yourself? Let us know in the comment section. So yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see you soon.